This morning on Go, Lister Sinclair presents The Masterpieces of Disco.
My name is Lister Sinclair, and welcome to this show called Go. Go. The masterpieces of Disco. Walter Hughes wrote a book called In the Empire of the Beat, Discipline and Disco. And this is some of the things he said. The oft-noted vacuity of the lyrics of disco songs is itself a part of the medium's message. Language is subjugated to the beat and drained of its pretensions to meaning. This emptying out of language parallels the refusal of narrative structure in the song overall. In the discotheque, the discotheque strives to shake off all remnants of its own textuality. They usually strive only to translate the rhetoric of the beat into simple imperatives. Imperatives such as, you should be dancing.
We'll be right back.
should be dancing, as commanded by the Bee Gees, one of the masterpieces of disco. That's the song that John Travolta displayed all alone on the dance floor, surrounded by admiring women and envious men, for the most part. That reminds me of the Lek. Lek, L-E-K. Now, it's going to sound as if I made this up, but anything that I make up is totally plausible, and this is not at all plausible, and therefore it's true. Many birds, many of the large birds, turkeys, for example, will do this, and grouse, they display fervently, but not the male displaying to the female. The males display to each other. And sometimes I think they're displaying actually to themselves. They're working themselves up into an orgy of displayfulness. And they're doing it on a small patch of ground, which is called a lek. And the females, rather drab-looking as a rule, are wandering around pretending to be unconcerned on the outside. In due course, the females will choose one of the males. The males have no choice in the matter whatsoever. The females do all the choosing. And in fact, it's been studied carefully, and it's discovered that out of 10 or a dozen male birds, one or perhaps two fertilize all the eggs. The females always tend to choose the head displayer. So, indeed, you should be dancing and doing as the birds do. Get tarted up in your very finest outfit. You should be wearing your boogie-woogie dancing shoes.
I'm sorry.
boogie-woogie dancing shoes. My name is Lister Sinclair, and welcome to this show called Go, but please don't. In the discotheque, the discotext strives to shake off all remnants of its own textuality, to become pure, unconstructed, undifferentiated discourse, this purity being another expression of its unmediated power to stimulate dancing. That's from Walter Hughes' book, In the Empire of the Beat, Discipline and Disco.
Lister Sinclair presents
The Masterpieces of Disco.
Nonsense can be truly nonsensical. There's a song that was around about 1830 in burlesque houses. And this certainly comes out at the end in genuinely nonsense syllables. They're pretty close to nonsense anyway. A mower mass I love a lass, as a cedar tall and slender. Sweet cowslip's grace is her nominative case, and she's of the feminine gender. Rorum corum sunt divorum, harum scarum devo, tag rag meridetti petty wig and hat band, hic hoc horum genitivo, and boogie woogie oogie by a taste of honey. Those were the sweet sounds of Boogie Oogie Oogie by A Taste of Honey.
This is Go.
Happy Radio.
There are many crisp, thoughtful, non-sentimental words in the old border ballads. This one was the favorite of the greatest Canadian, Tommy Douglas. And it's from an old border ballad about an old, old battle. And somebody is wounded. And what happens? The guy who's wounded says, I'll just lie down and bleed a while. And then stand up and fight again. Kung Fu Fighting by Carl Douglas. No relation.
Oh, oh, oh. Everybody was kung fu fighting. Those kids were fast as lightning. In fact, it was a little bit frightening. But they fought with expert timing. There were funky China men from funky Chinatown. They were chopping them up. They were chopping them.
Douglas and Tommy Douglas. I guess that is a little bit frightening. I'm Brent Bambury, and today on Go, it is the masterpieces of disco music, as presented by Lister Sinclair. But first, who said God had to create disco so that I could be born and be successful? Was it Maurice Gibb, Donna Summer, or the policeman from The Village People? We'll find out right after this.
Anything can happen on Go.
CBC Radio Go.
Canadian disco twin spin.
Okay, so Canada didn't produce a pile of disco masterpieces, but I was looking through Go's vintage vinyl collection, and I found a few pieces of classic 70s Canadiana. Our first twin spin of Canadian disco hits comes from the funkiest province in the country. Of course I mean Quebec, also known as Patti LaBelle Province, and the pulsating rhythms of France Jolie's Come to Me with Patsy Glance from New York to L.A.
There's a face on my lips, there's a name in my life, there's no place. for the man that I love. 'Cause I'm living my life just to sing and be free. From LA to New York, from New York to LA.
Jolie and Patsy Galant, and we'll have more Canadian disco hits coming up. Now, who said God had to create disco so I could be born and be successful? Maurice Gibb, Donna Summer, or the cop from the Village People? That's right, it's Donna Summer. God looks out for bad girls.
It's been so long.
You're listening to Go on CBC Radio 1, and now, back to the man who puts the chic in le freak, Lister Sinclair.
All this has been going on a long time. Shakespeare and his friends, Campion, for example, loved the single entendre. Here's a little song that Campion wrote his own words. Sweet Cupid, ripen her desire, thy joyful harvest to begin. If old age grow a little nigher, 'twill be too late to get it in. The harvest takes place in the fall, of course, but this goes on all the year round. Bad Girls is by Donna Summer.
Beep.
Well, that's wonderful. My name is Lister Sinclair, and D is for disco, and D is for Donna Summer, Bad Girls. In another familiar disco masterpiece, Cool and the Gang implore us to get down on it. Dear, dear, what is it, and what are we supposed to do when we get down? Well, as Walter Hughes says, this emptying out of language parallels the refusal of narrative structure in the song overall. There is rarely an identifiable direction, progression, or climax in disco music. The prolongation of its own continuity is its only end. Cool and the Gang, get down on it.
What you gonna do?
Groove shake.
You wanna get down? Tell me. What you gonna do?
Groove shake.
Do you wanna get down?
Get down on it.
What you gonna do? You wanna get down? What you gonna do? You wanna get down? Tell me.
Get down on it.
Get down on it. Get down on it. Get down on it. Get down on it.
Come on in. By standing on the wall,
get your back up off the wall.
Tell me, how you gonna do it if you really don't wanna dance? By standing on the wall,
get your back up off the wall.
'Cause I heard all the people saying,
get down on it,
come on in,
get down on it.
If you really want it,
get down on it.
You gotta feel it. Get on the groove if you want your body to move. Tell me, baby, how you gonna do it if you really don't wanna dance? By standing on the wall,
get your back up off the wall.
Tell me, how you gonna do it if you really won't take a chance? By standing on the wall,
get your back up off the wall.
'Cause I heard all the people saying,
come on in. Get down on it.
want it.
Get down on it.
You gotta feel it.
Get down on
get
it.
Get down on it.
Get down on it.
Get down.
Come on
in.
Get down on it.
Baby, baby.
Get down on
get
it.
Get on it.
Get down on it.
How you gonna do it if you really don't wanna dance? By standing on the wall.
Get your back up off the wall.
Tell me, baby. How you gonna do it if you really won't take a chance? By standing on the wall.
Get your back up off the wall.
Listen, baby. You know it. Oh, when you're dancing, yeah. You show it. Oh, when you move, move, move. You know it. Oh, when you're dancing, yeah. You show it. As you move across the floor.
Get down on it.
Come on in.
Get down on
it. If you really want it.
Down. What you gonna do?
Get your back up off the wall. Dance, come on. Get your back up off the wall. Dance, come on. Get down on it.
Come on in.
Get down on
if you really want it.
Get down on it.
You gotta feel it.
Get down on
get down
it.
On it.
Get down on it.
Come on in.
Get down on it.
Get down on it.
Get down on it.
While you're dancing.
Get down on
get
it.
Down on
Cool and the gang got down on it, and there they are, still busying themselves, no doubt. For a moment there I felt a sense of panic, meaning I didn't quite remember what I was supposed to say next. But that isn't real panic. Real panic is something quite different, and I have once experienced it. Real panic is the unreasoning fear of the wilderness itself. It's the fear of the great god Pan. And the great god Pan can get to you if you suddenly show up in his wilderness. One time I was driving, for the first time indeed, through the great redwood forest in California. It was night, and we stopped the car. And I got out and, with a flashlight, walked in among those enormous redwoods. There was a moon, so there was a bit of light around, and then I turned off the flashlight. And panic really hit me. It's not that there were bad animals out there, or even good animals. It wasn't that there were bad guys or even good guys out there. It's that there was nothing in particular out there. But everything was inside me. That was true panic. And I got back to the road as fast as I could and left in a very great hurry. Panic is real. But is Pan real? Is the boogeyman real? Well, of course, if you believe in them, and of course not if you don't.
I'm your boogeyman. We'll be right back.
I'm Your Boogeyman by KC and the Sunshine Band.
This is Go.
Boney M would have us believe that Rasputin was Russia's greatest love machine. This strange, scruffy monk certainly had irresistible influence over the Tsarina, the wife of the Tsar. She had given birth to a son with a terrible disease of haemophilia, passed on through mothers, suffered by sons. Rasputin's combination of prayers, potions, placebos, and bits of magic completely gripped the Tsarina. When the aristocrats decided that he had to be liquidated, they tried to poison him. Didn't work. Then they shot him quite a lot. Didn't work. Then they tied him up tight and chucked him into the Neva River as it ran by St. Petersburg. Rasputin got out of the duct tape or whatever and swam away. But in the end, he drowned. Boney M. sticks to the Russian romance department.
so long ago.
He was big and strong, in his eyes a flaming glow.
Most people look at him with terror and the fear.
But to Moscow chicks, he was such a lovely dear. He could preach the Bible like a preacher, full of ecstasy and fire. But he also was the kind of teacher women would desire. Rah-rah, Rasputin, lover of the Russian queen. There was a cat that really was gone. Rah-rah, Rasputin, Russia's greatest love machine. It was a shame how he carried on.
And his hunger for power became known to more and more people. The demands to do something about this outrageous man became louder and louder.
You know, I always thought the line was "rah rah Rasputin, lover of the Russian team," like he was some sort of disco talisman for Russia's Red Army hockey team. Didn't work for them in 1972. And speaking of Canada in the 70s, it is time for more
Canadian Disco Twin Spin.
Yes, Canada wasn't just a sea of mullets and toques in the 70s. We also pranced in polyester on the dance floor. Our next Canadian Disco Twin Spin includes the big hair of the new wave band Lime, and our own disco queen, Denise McCann's Tattoo Man.
Down in the streets, there's a man they call Tattoo Man. He likes his sweets and he takes his sugar when he can. He tells them all if they're thinking about going straight.
Tattoo Man,
my strength's wearing thin.
Well, that's wonderful.